Hello, I'm Thomas from Game for Automation. I would like to show you today how CIMID from Siemens can be connected to the game engine Unity. This is especially useful for virtual commissioning in the machinery industry. CIMID can be used for modeling the intelligent field bus devices as well as interface between Unity and the PLC. For showing you the functions, I prepared a small demo model based on the Game for Automation framework, which is for free available. The demo consists of a small conveyor, a source for cans, and in yellow, the light barrier, which is detecting the cans which are colliding with it. The conveyor is already having a drive component. Now we add a behavior model for the drive, which is acting as an interface towards CIMID. Next, we will pick the CIMID interface out of the Game for Automation library and drag it into the scene. Let's position it here. Now we change to CIMID for setting the right interface settings. Here we are. And as you can see, already some inputs and outputs are defined. Now we start CIMID. Okay, let's skip the demo message. It might take some time until CIMID is started, and when CIMID is simulating, it's getting orange like it is right now. Let's get back to the 3D model. Now, because CIMID is running, we can import the signals and we will see directly all signals in Unity which are available from CIMID. They are created as objects in our scene. We will now need to connect these signals to the behavior model of the drive. So let's open the conveyor and here we have got our behavior model. And we just take the signals and drag them to the behavior model value where we would like them to be connected. Okay, that's all for a simple drive. Next, we are going to connect the sensor. Let's go to the sensor. And here we also drag one signal to our sensor occupied signal. That's later on the PLC input. Now let's arrange our screens a little bit so that we can see on the right hand side CIMID and on the left hand side our 3D model. We can start it. So we need to start Unity, our 3D model, and now we can push the output to high and this will start the conveyor in Unity to move. And as soon as the cans are colliding, right now you see that the sensor is getting an high. We can also revert the conveyor and the cans will move in the opposite direction. On the left hand side, you see in the hierarchy scene view, the values of our signals. They are changing from false to true. That's giving you a full control over the values and their current status. As soon as we are stopping CIMID, you will see the values are getting gray. This means that they are not connected anymore to CIMID. On top of it, we could also control the values itself or override them with certain values. As soon as we are starting CIMID again, you will see that CIMID will now automatically reconnect to the CIMID model. And the values are getting back red for PLC inputs or green for PLC outputs. also possible to add additional values at any time. So let's add here my new signal. And now let's change it here to a real value. Let's save it and start sim it. And as soon as we are starting the 3D model, the value will be automatically generated during startup. So now Simit is started and you directly see the new signal inside the signal list in the hierarchy view in Unity. That's a real value. Let's change it to a new value. So, and directly the value is also shown in Unity. For making the signal available all the time, we should import it before starting the simulation. This means that the value will be added permanently to the scene. I'm now starting back again the conveyor, and the cans will start to move as shown before. That's all for now. Please check our website for further information and for all the possibilities to download our solution.